Space, the final frontier.
I'm 34 years old.
Is this your brother, Jim?
Was my brother.
I'm sorry, Jim.
My brother's son.
I am Cordos, if it pleases you to believe so. I'm an actor. I play many parts.
You're an actor now. What were you 20 years ago?
Younger, Captain. Much younger.
According to our library banks, it started on the Earth colony of Tarsus IV when the food supply was attacked by an exotic fungus and largely destroyed. There were over 8,000 colonists and virtually no food. And that was when Governor Kodos seized full power and declared emergency martial law.
The revolution is successful, but survival depends on drastic measures. Your continued existence represents a threat to the well-being of society. Your lives mean slow death the more valued members of the colony. Therefore, I have no alternative but to sentence you to death. Your executioner so ordered, signed Kodos, governor of Tarsus IV.
Kodos began to separate the colonists. Some would live, be rationed whatever food was left. The remainder would be immediately put to death. Apparently, he had his own theories of eugenics.
Unfortunately, he wasn't the first.
Perhaps not. But he was certainly among the most ruthless to decide arbitrarily who would survive and who would not, using his own personal standards, and then to implement his decision without mercy. Children watching their parents die, whole families destroyed, over 4,000 people. They died quickly, without pain. But they died. Relief arrived, but too late to prevent the executions. And Kodos, there never was a positive identification of his body.
But what is Caridian to do with it?
His history begins almost to the day where Kodos disappeared.
And you think Jem suspects he's Kodos?
He'd better. There were 9 eyewitnesses who survived the massacre, who'd actually seen Kodos with their own eyes. Jim Kirk was one of them. With the exception of Riley and Captain Kirk, every other eyewitness is dead. And my library computer shows that wherever they were, on Earth, on a colony, or aboard ship, the Caridian company of players was somewhere near when they died.
It's unbelievable.
Hey, man, I remember you back at the academy. A stack of books with legs. The first thing I ever heard from an upperclassman was, "Watch out for Lieutenant Kirk. In his class, you either think or sink."
That wasn't that bad, was it?
If I hadn't aimed that little Blom lab technician at you.
You what? You planned that?
Well, you wanted me to think, didn't you? I outlined her whole campaign for her.
I almost married her.
Sir, may I ask you a question?
What's on your mind, Lieutenant?
The Kobayashi Maru, sir.
Are you asking me if we're playing out that scenario now?
On the test, sir. Will you tell me what you did? I would really like to know.
Lieutenant, you are looking at the only Starfleet cadet who ever beat the no-win scenario.
How?
I reprogrammed the simulation so it was possible to rescue the ship.
What?
He cheated.
I changed the conditions of the test. Got a commendation for original thinking. I don't like to lose.
Then you never faced that situation. Faced death.
I don't believe in the no-win scenario.
We're surrounded by Romulan vessels. Maximum of 10. Range, 50 to 100,000 kilometers.
Engineering, this is the captain. I want full emergency power. I want everything within about 2 minutes. I want the warp drive engines on full standby. Kirk up. Open up a special channel to Starfleet Command.
Aye, sir.
Code 2.
But, Captain, code...
That's an order, Lieutenant. Code 2.
Yes, Captain. Code 2.
Message. From Enterprise to Starfleet Command this sector. Have inadvertently encroached upon Romulan neutral zone, surrounded and under heavy Romulan attack. Escape impossible, shields failing. Will implement destruct order using Cobramite device recently installed. Since this will result in the destruction of the Enterprise and all matter within a 200,000 kilometer diameter and establish a corresponding dead zone, all Federation ships will avoid this area for the next 4 solar years. Explosion will take place in 1 minute. Kirk, commanding Enterprise, out. Mr. Sulu, course 188 degrees, mark 14. Speed, warp factor 8. Stand by.
Standing by, sir.
Romulans giving ground, Captain. Obviously, they tapped in as you expected them to.
A logical assumption, Mr. Spock. Are they still retreating?
Yes, sir.
He's got to get a tractor beam. Tractor beam's on.
Warp factor 8, now.
Romulans were cut off guard, Captain. They're falling behind.
Are we out of range, Mr. Sulu?
Yes, sir. And out of the neutral zone.
Secure from red alert. Adjust a new course, 257 degrees, mark 3. Heading for Starbase 10.
257 degrees, mark 3.
Have you studied the incident involving the USS Farragut?
No, with all these deaths and injuries, I've only had a chance to scan the tapes. There are 8 or 10 hours of record tapes there.
Fortunately, I read somewhat faster. In brief, Doctor, nearly half the crew and the captain were annihilated. The captain's name was Garavik.
Same as our ensign.
His father. Among the survivors was a young officer on his first deep space assignment. James T. Kirk.
Lieutenant James T. Kirk of the starship Farragut. 11 years ago, you were the young officer at a phaser station when something attacked. According to the tapes, this young Lieutenant Kirk insisted upon blaming himself.
Because I delayed in firing it.
You had a normal emotion. You were startled. You delayed firing for a grand total of perhaps 2 seconds.
If I hadn't delayed, it would have been killed.
Well, the ship's exec didn't seem to think so. His log entry was quite clear on the subject. Lieutenant Kirk is a fine young officer who performed with uncommon bravery.
Don't you understand? It killed 200 crewmen.
Captain Garavik was very important to you, wasn't he, Jim?
Yes. He's my commanding officer from the day I left the academy. One of the finest men I ever knew. Oh, Ensign. Meet me in my quarters when you've cleaned up. I'd like to talk to you about your father. Several tall stories I think you'd like to hear.
Thank you, sir. I would.
You ever met Chris Pike?
We met when he was promoted to fleet captain. I took over the Enterprise from Spock, served with him for several years.
11 years, 4 months, 5 days.
About your age, big, handsome man, vital, active.
Gary told me that you've been friends since he joined the service, that you asked for him aboard your first command.
Hello, Jim. Hey, you look worried.
I've been worried about you ever since that night on Denim 4.
Yeah, she was Nova, that one.
My friend, James Kirk. Remember those rodent things on Dimerus? The poison darts they threw? I took one meant for you.
And almost died. I remember.